Hello friends, welcome to Love to Code. My name is Nawaz and in this video I am going to discuss one of the problems which was asked in Zoho interview, that is to design an automated rate traffic controller. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and hit the bell icon. If Zoho is your dream company, watch this video till the end so that it will be very much helpful for you to prepare for advanced programming round. I would recommend you to take pen and paper, note down the problem statement while watching this video and try to solve this by yourself before I publish a solution. I have split this problem into two videos. In part 1, I will be discussing only the question. In part 2, I will be discussing about the solution. So let's start. So here are the screenshots that I took during my interview at Zoho. So these are the screenshots. So let us discuss the problem statement. Here we have to design an automated air traffic controller. So we are to write a program logic that will automate the task of an air traffic controller. So we will be given with predefined information of flights, runways and conditions for landing and taking off, with which you have to compute the correct runway for incoming and outgoing flights. So the overall problem is that we have to write a program logic to automate a task of an air traffic controller, where a predefined information about flights and runways will be given along with the conditions for landing and takeoff. We have to compute a correct runway for incoming and outgoing flights. So the terminologies used in this problem are touchdown. Touchdown means a moment at which the flight touches the ground. So time to halt. Time taken after touchdown to become fully stopped. So time taken to take off. So taxiing, moving the plane to designated stop for landing or runway for takeoff. So the information about flights is given. So the data given here represents the time for a flight to come to halt in a runway after touchdown. It always assumed that the touchdown speed and takeoff speed is 200 km per hour. So the type of flights are ATR, Airbus, Boeing, cargo, and the maximum weight is in terms of tons. For ATR it is 12 tons, for Airbus it is 20 tons, for Boeing it is 40 tons, for cargo it is 100 tons. If I am spelling Boeing, if I am pronouncing Boeing wrong, please neglect that. I am not able to pronounce a proper word for that. And also they have given the information of time taken to halt or take off for a particular flight. For example, for an ATR it is 30 seconds and for an Airbus it is 40 seconds. So we will take an example for Airbus. Airbus can carry maximum of 20 tons and time to halt or take off with 20 tons is 40 seconds. So here is the condition to calculate time and weight. The time to halt decreases with decrease in weight. We can assume that weight follows the time decrease 10% of each of the three weight ranges. That is, if the weight is greater than 75%, it will take maximum time. So if the weight is between 50% to 75%, the time taken is 10% less than the maximum time, and if the time is less, if the weight is less than 50%, so the time taken is maximum time minus 20% of maximum time. For example, ATR takes 30 seconds to halt or take off with 9+ tons, that is above 75%, and ATR takes 27 seconds, that is 10% of 30 seconds, that is 3 minus 30 seconds to halt or take off with 6+ tons to 9 tons, that is greater than 50 and lesser than 75%, and ATR takes 24 seconds, that is 20% of 30 seconds to halt or take off with less than 6 tons, that is lesser than 50%. Here I am referring 20% of 30 seconds means we should subtract 30 minus 20% of 30, that will give us 24. So this is the condition which we need to compute. So what actually happens is if you want to land or take off an ATR flight and it carries a weight about 10 tons, then the time taken to land or take off is 30 seconds. Like that only, if ATR has a weight of 6 plus tons to 9 tons, so the time taken is 30 minus 10% of 30 seconds. Similarly, for ATR with weight less than 6 tons, that is less than 50%, it will take 30 minus 20% of 30 seconds. So this is a condition for a flight to land or take off with respective side weight, with respective their weights. So we need to calculate these things. We have to write one function or method to calculate these things. We should keep this in our mind. So this is one of the conditions. So here is the detail for a runway. So they did given data here represent the maximum time a flight can run with its maximum capacity in a runway after touchdown. Touchdown means after touching that runway. So there are four runways and each runway has its own time. So in runway 1, a flight can with maximum time 40 seconds or lesser can run on runway 1. And in runway 2, a flight with maximum time 60 seconds or lesser than that can run. And in runway 3, a flight with maximum time of 80 seconds or lesser than that can run. And in runway 4, a flight with maximum 90 seconds or lesser than that can run. So it is always advised to alert a runway to any aircraft with at least 10 seconds extra time than the incoming aircraft time to halt. This is one of the notes and this is one of the condition which is very much important. For example, if ATR at its full capacity can land or take off in any runway. So let me show you what is the time for an ATR with its full capacity. So ATR with maximum, that is full capacity, is 12 tons and time to halt or take off is 30 seconds. So ATR can take off or land in any of these runways since 30 is lesser than 40, 60, 80 and 90. So Airbus at its full capacity can land or take off in any of 2, 3 and 4 runways. Let us see the maximum capacity of Airbus. I'm extremely sorry for pronouncing ATR, it is Airbus. So the maximum ton of weight is 20 tons and the time to take off or halt is 40 seconds. So for Airbus, it can land or take off in runway 2, runway 3, runway 4 or any of these runways since the time is lesser than the runway time. So Airbus at greater than 50%, that is time to halt is 32 seconds. For Airbus, maximum weight is 20 and the time to halt is 40 seconds. So if Airbus with greater than 50%, if Airbus at lesser than 50% of its maximum weight can halt, can take a time of 32 seconds, it can land or take off in any of the runways, that is runway 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the task of an air traffic controller will be like, it should handle the takeoff request, landing request and emergency landing request. There are three types of request, you have to remember this, that is one is takeoff request, landing request and emergency landing request. So whenever there is a takeoff or landing request, the air traffic controller should get some information from the user, that is, it should get the type of a flight and its weight, and it should compute a correct runway for a particular flight. If there are no runways available, we can either ask to retry after 30 seconds or add the request in the queue. It is purely on you whether you want to ask a user to retry after 30 seconds or add the request into the queue. So we have to assign a runway for a flight and mark the runway as engaged. We also need to free the runway after takeoff is done based on runway time. So in air traffic controller, there will be multiple requests in short time. Each request should be handled separately in a queue if possible. After providing the solution, it will be 15 seconds wait time before process is initiated. For example, if you have assigned runway 1 for ATR, it will be 60 seconds wait time for runway 1. That is total 15 seconds wait time plus 45 seconds runway time. And the next flight will be assigned for runway 1 only after 60 seconds. Here we are taking 50 seconds as buffer time. So whenever there is any request, we have to compute time based on its weight, and we should add 15 seconds buffer, that is extra waiting time, and check whether any runway with the total time is free or it can take this flight for takeoff or landing request. And there is special and priority for emergency landing. That is, emergency landing will be necessary whenever there is an issue in flight. Whenever there is emergency landing request, the longest available or applicable runway must be made free. Handling the current request, or if it is free, it should be handled straight away. The waiting time should be minimal. For example, if you are getting any emergency landing request, you have to assign a runway with maximum long time, available time. If that runway is busy with any other request, you should wait and then assign this emergency landing request to that particular runway, and the waiting time should be very much minimal. So our program needs to address few test cases, and our program will be tested against few test cases. And while programming, you need to think or remember of few tips or logics. That is, landing is always higher priority than takeoff. If you are getting any request, that is a landing request, you have to always give a priority for that other than takeoff. The shortest runway always are allocated first. For example, runway 1 is a shortest runway. So runway 2, that is 30 or 40 seconds. Runway 2 is 60 seconds. Suppose there is a flight with 40 seconds, you have to assign runway 1. If there are more than 4 requests, the next request should be put on hold for 1 minute after fetching applicable runway details. We have to keep these things while programming or building a design. So the request should be not put to wait for more than 3 times. That is, if we are repeatedly sending request, it should not be put for hold more than 3 times. Emergency landing should be always put in longest available runway. So whenever we are getting any emergency landing request, it should be always given to a longest available runway. We have to take care of this things while designing a logic for this program. So here are the test cases. We have to handle at least 2 takeoff and 2 landing requests for cargo and 2 ATR. Handle 4 landing requests of ATR flights of different weight. Handle landing request for 2 cargos, 1 ATR and 1 Airbus. Handle landing request of 1 Boeing, 1 ATR, 1 cargo with less than 50% of its maximum weight. Handle multiple requests and show waiting and queued flights details. So we have to also show the waiting and queued flight details whenever whenever the interviewer will ask, we have to show these details. Emergency landing of different flights with different capacity. We also need to handle few emergency landing requests. We have to show the runway status anytime. That is, if the interviewer gives you some request and he will ask us to print the status of any of the all the runways at any time, we have to print whether that runway is engaged or free. So here is a sample input. The program should be interactive and the process the output on its input. For example, we have to design such way that there should be a request, and we should tell which kind of a request the user wants to give. Here, 1 represents a takeoff request, 2 represents a landing request, 3 represents the emergency landing request. I would also recommend you to add any other number 4, that is to print the status of runway, and number 5 to print the status of queued flight details. Okay, so that based on that you can show the input and output. So this was actually this was the sample input given in the problem statement while I wrote a Zoho interview. So the interviewer in between, he will tell you to add few things. So you should not tell like it is not mentioned in a problem statement, so I will not complete. The interviewer wants to know whether if some additional task is given for you, how you will react for that. So in this case, what happens is they will give you some problem statement. In between that, they will come and tell you, please add few additional tasks, please remove this, please change this and check. So like this, the interviewer will test you how you are responding to these queries. So the sample input was given like this. So we will take what kind of request. So he should be able to enter the request type. So whenever after entering a request type, you should show him the type of planes available. Here there are 4 planes, that is ATR, Airbus, Boeing and cargo. We have to select a particular flight or a plane. So I am going to select Airbus, and then we have to compute the weight based on the maximum weight. For Airbus, the maximum weight, I think it is, let me see the maximum weight for Airbus. So the maximum weight for Airbus is 20 tons. So let me go to, yeah, so the maximum weight is 20 tons. So first one will be more than 75%, that is 15, more than 15 tons, and the second type will be 75 to 50%, that is 10 to 15, and the third weight is less than 50%. So by keeping that maximum weight of a particular flight, we have to compute this data, that is the weight of a plane. So after this, we should ask the user to select the type of weight. So here he is selecting 3, that is less than 50%. So now we have to compute the total time taken by Airbus. So in this case, Airbus will take, so the output will be, Airbus will take almost 35 seconds to touch down. So we have to print the output in this order. We have to give an approval for Airbus with less than 10 tons of weight, and we are landing is up, we should print like landing is approved for Airbus with less than 10 tons of weight in runway 1, and we should give the buffer time, that is 15 seconds which I talked previously. So the buffer time will be 15 seconds, touchdown will happen in 15 seconds, the plane will stop after 35 seconds of touchdown, and runway 1 will be ready for next request in 1 minute. So we have to show tell this runway 1 will be available for next request in 1 minute, that is 35 plus 15 plus 10 seconds is a buffer time. We also should take care of this. If you have any doubt here, you will get one doubt like the touchdown will happen in 15 seconds and the plane will stop after 35 seconds of touchdown, and the runway 1 has a maximum time of 40 seconds. 35 plus 15 is 40-50, but actually 50 runway 1 can have only 40 seconds. How it is taking 50 seconds time? So in this example, you have many questions. So here they are not including 15 seconds waiting time to calculate the runway, but they are going to display you and they are going to mark this runway 1 as engaged for this particular time. After serving the request of the plane, that is 35 seconds of touchdown, they are again giving buffer time of 10 seconds. You have to ask interviewer whether you should clear your doubts before solving any problem. Before solving this problem, you have to clear the doubts with the interviewer, what how it is calculated and why it is like this and why we are waiting for 1 minute, so that you will get a clear idea. So the second test case is similar to that one. Here we are using cargo, and we have calculated different weights for cargo, and we are selecting the weight, and we are approving a landing for cargo with 50 to 75 tons of weight in runway 3. Touchdown will take in 15 seconds. Plane will stop after 69 seconds of touchdown. The runway 3 will be ready for next request in 1 minute 9 seconds. Actually, I think I have made a mistake here. So please correct this mistake. It will be available in 35 seconds. Runway 1 will be available in 35 seconds. After 35 seconds, please correct this mistake. I'm extremely sorry. It would have been a printing mistake. So in actual sample output, there will be printing mistakes as well. Since I have copied this question from the screenshots, I have directly written, but I remember that when I had a doubt and asked the interviewer, he explained me we should have 15 seconds buffer time, and the computer time will be given, will be used to engage the runway. So here is a third sample request. So in this request also, I am choosing what kind of a request and then what kind of flight and its weight. So here is a sample output. In this, finding runway to land Airbus with 75 tons. No runway is free now for landing. Please try after 45 seconds. So how I am telling 45 seconds, why not 30 seconds? So I might know that runway 1 can complete its request in 45 seconds. I can allocate this request to that runway. So I am telling to try after 45 seconds. If there are no runway free, we can print the output in this format. So this is one of the sample output. So there will be more kind of test cases which interviewer will be having in his mind, but not on the problem statement. It is recommended for you to understand complete problem statement design properly and then and try to solve the problem. So for this, I will give you a short tip how I solved this problem is. So almost I took 30 minutes to go through all the pages of this problem statement. Then I realized I will not be able to crack, but somehow I got an idea what are the things to use. So what in interview, what things I used was, so I saved the information of flights in one hash map, which will contain the hash map will have key as ATR, and it will have another value as another hash map, and that hash map will have weight as key and value as 12 and the time as 30 seconds. I will have computed all these values in a hash map for the flight details, and I also used this formula. I wrote one method to calculate the time of a flight based on weight. This will be a separate method, and then I had used one array list where hash map where I will be setting a key as runway 1 and value will be true or false whether it is engaged or not. So then after that what I did was I had used a queue linked list to store the incoming request. So in interview I was not able to give the solution for landing is always higher priority than takeoff. So I was not able to do that, and I was able to do the shorter runways are allocated first, and I was able to do that more than four request. If there are more than four requests, I asked them to retry. And for emergency landing, I always give a longest runway available. So I was not able to handle that is landing priority. What I was doing, whatever the request I was getting, I was adding to a linked list. And that was a silly thing I was doing. Actually, the interviewer was impressed with what I did. So to engage or mark a runway available or free for a particular time, I used threads. So I declared a thread class and I called a thread by passing a runway name, and I used a thread.sleep so that that runway will be engaged for a particular time. In this way I solved, made the runways engaged. At last I was not able to solve landing priority. I was able to print the runway details whether it is engaged or not. I was able to print the request details. So it after 30 minutes I explained to the interviewer that I will be using a linked list to store all the requests. I will be using threads to engage or mark the runway free, and other things I will be doing normally, that to calculate based on formula. I will be calculating the weight for a particular flight. Once the interviewer spoke to me about the design, he said to proceed with coding. So I started coding. Almost it took 2 hours. In 2 hours I was able to print a sample input 1, and I was able to assign runway 1 for sample input 1. So after that they gave me some break, so we went for lunch, and again we came back and we continued with the programming. It almost took 4 to 5 hours. I think it is took 4 to 5 hours. Finally I was a good among those 5 people. I did many modules. I cleared many modules, so they asked me to come for a technical HR round.
So finally we will decide one thing. For any flight, if we select any flight and we are computing time based on weight and we are getting time as 30 seconds, we'll add 15 seconds extra time to that, and 30 plus 15 will give 45. We'll check any runway which is available with 45 seconds and we'll assign to that particular runway. I have talked to interviewers, since there will be many mistakes in question paper, they suggested me to do like this. So I will show you what was the mistake is. So they gave one condition telling that there should be a buffer time of 10 seconds. And then in examples, they are giving waiting time of 15 seconds. So this makes us confusion. See here, they have mentioned that each runway should have extra time of 10 seconds. And in this example, they are telling like the waiting time should be 15 seconds. So finally, after discussing with the interviewer, we should finalize, we should get to one solution problem. So our problem will be like, we are computing time for a particular flight based on weight. Suppose we are getting 45 seconds, we'll add 15 seconds as buffer, and we'll check whether any runway with available 60 seconds, and we'll assign to that. After 60 seconds, we'll make that runway free. So finally, we'll decide with this, and we'll try to solve. You all try to solve this problem. I will also start coding for this problem, and I will come with a solution in the upcoming video.
I would recommend you to try to solve this problem on your own. Subscribe to my channel to see this code solution. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, subscribe and share.